Hey everyone, Shaber 1000 here. Today I got some items here we're gonna be checking out. This is all has to do with my sister's wedding. Monkey's over here behind me on the couch. And she's kind of rolling her eyes at me because I forgot to turn the mic on again. So let's see what we got. Okay guys, I'll show you the first thing we got here. Get this opened up. I still got one more thing coming in. This was supposed to be in tomorrow. So I got everything except one thing. So this is one of the things I got. Cool. This is my belt and belt buckle. This is a vintage buckle. It is, I think it's a 1994. So I'll get that on my buffing wheel. And that'll look cool. Alright. Now the next one I have to show you. This is this big one. And I got two other things there. So this big one here, let me see. Whoops. Okay, I'll probably have to bring it out for this. She's rolling her eyes again. Horrible weekend, guys.
For you.
For me.
No, I had a great time.
She had a great time, as you'll see. If you've watched her video, you'll see it in my video too. She's like, you want to show it in your camera too? Because she knew I would put it in. Alright, so this is from the boot barn. It's a new pair of boots for my sister's wedding. Well, I've been wanting a new pair for a long time. I guess Sissy's wedding just gave us an excuse to get them, huh?
Yep.
Oh, I can smell that leather. Already. Okay, so open these up. Just hope they fit because I had to order them online. So
we were
kind of guessing from other measurements and stuff.
Oh, those are pretty.
Check these out, guys.
Oh, they're nice. Oh.
Those are awesome. Love the smell of leather. These are really nice. So I got these now. The other items have to do with those. So let's get these opened up here. Let's see. Open this up. Hey, we got more poppy envelope.
Yeah.
So when we send out more stuff. Every time I go to send out something, where's all those poppies we had? Oh no. I know what's happening to them.
What?
Monkey popping them. Monkey's popping them. She just pop, 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 and then throws them away, and I don't have nothing to send out packages. Because we needed some. I sold something on eBay the other day, and we needed some. And we sent something out, and we could have used them. Tack discounters. And a lot of you guys might know what these are, but some of you may not, and I'll show you in a minute for the ones that don't. But this is the Praying Cowboy by Cross. Those are nice. Now those have to do with this, which all has to do, well, except for the belt, with that. And here we go. Let's open these up so you can see them better. Man, I smell that leather too from this now. Cool. These are my Spurs, which are the Praying Cowboy at the cross. And these are the straps that go with the praying cowboy spurs. Well, those are pretty. Pretty cool. Pretty awesome. Now, I'm going to go ahead. First things first, let's open this up. This is vacuum packed. You don't want leather to get moist, so that's good. Hi, Mama.
Yeah.
So, let's get these out of here.
I'll try your boots on first.
Okay, I'm getting to that.
They look pretty. They'll look nice on those boots. They look really nice.
Oops. Chairs. So yeah, those are gonna look cool with the praying cowboy.
Oh yeah,
that looks
nice.
Alright, what these do is they come around and see, it'd be this one.
Are you gonna make noise when you walk?
I will jingle jangle jingle.
Well, you'd be like Santa.
Well, okay, yeah, I'll be like Santa. So these will go on like this, and they hold your spurs on, so you get that and that there. All right, so there's left and right. So we're gonna get this out. We're gonna try it on. Hopefully, it will fit. Make sure everything's out of there. Yep. All right, let's point you down here. We'll try them on. Okay, guys. I got my Papa Bear, my little Papa Bear slippers on. Okay, here's the moment of truth. Let's see if these puppies will fit. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay, so I got to get this thing out.
Well, don't you
want to
walk
it? In a minute. I gotta get the other one ready. I gotta get this thing out. Just that little tag. Let's get the other one here out. And nicely boxed, by the way. Boot Barn. These were $140, these boots.
Yeah, they're on sale.
Yeah. They are, shoot, I forget, what are they? What line are they? Moonshine. Brad Paisley line. Right here it is. See? It's Moonshine Spirit by Brad Paisley. So that's cool. No, he never worn them, guys, but just to be a part of that. Right?
Yeah.
So, keep you in frame here best I can.
Pretty.
These are badass. I'll be up on stage with him. He'll be like, oh, you bought a pair of my boots. All right. Come up on stage with me. I'll be like, okay, I guess so. All right. Let's get these on. I wish I had a pair of boot pools that she had.
Yeah.
At the one place we went to.
Yeah, that was kind of neat.
Yeah.
Did you tell them that story?
I do not think I did.
Maybe.
Okay. Alright. Story time. So what we did was the other day, we went to
a leather shop.
Over here, what, Crystal River?
Yeah.
So, just a couple miles up the road, really. And this old lady standing outside. She's how old? 80?
Yeah.
80 years old. Standing outside, and the shop looks nice. Looks like brand new. Beautiful shop. She's standing outside in her house coat, well, robe and slippers. Mm-hmm. Had the door locked, and you know, monkey told her or her to get some things Western style for a wedding. She's like, okay, well, we was in there, what, 2 hours?
Yeah.
And we tried on, I found a pair of boots that fit fine. That's how we kind of knew what size to get, because she measured my foot and everything, and we had like almost $300 worth of stuff, like $268, $262 worth of stuff.
Yeah.
And we go to check out, and still didn't have everything. Still didn't have a belt. Still didn't have a bolo.
No, because her belts didn't fit you.
Yeah.
And the bolo that, well, I had the bolo. I was going to buy that little heavy thing.
Oh, yeah, we did have a bolo.
But there was something else was missing.
What a bolo is, for those of you that, I'm sorry, Mike. It's like a real thin tie.
Right.
I'll show it in one of my videos. Well, I'll just do a video on it tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And it's a real thin tie, and they're really neat. They're round.
And it's, it got a little ornament on it.
Yeah, it's a tie that cowboys wear.
Right.
Which I ordered a vintage one.
Mm-hmm.
So, also my thing should be in tomorrow too.
Oh, the little tips.
Yeah, the tips. I'll show you about that. But it's supposed to be very old. So that'll be cool. It looked like it was in decent shape. It's leather. But we did have that. We had that, a shirt, and a pair of boots, wasn't it? A bolo, a shirt, and a pair of boots.
Yeah.
And her boots, they were just black boots. They didn't have heel guards, toe guards, nothing. Just a plain black pair of leather boots. And yeah, they were $160 themselves.
Yeah.
Well, so we go to check out, and, well, she says, I don't take the card. I can't take the card. The credit card machine is not working.
Yeah.
This was after everything was added up, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, then, she could barely add anything.
Yeah, she couldn't. She couldn't add it up. She had her little adding machine there, but it kept coming up an error. She was out of ink.
I don't think she knew what she was.
So she had Monkey had to add it all up for her.
On her phone,
on the calculator, and got it all added up. And then that's when she says, well, my card machine, it don't work. You need to go up the road here to get cash.
Yeah, out of the ATM.
After 2 hours out of our day, she tells us this at the end.
Right.
So we did go to the ATM. We thought about going somewhere else, and so we did go to the ATM machine, and, they were out of money. So I was like, you know what? That just pissed me off anyway. She was a grumpy old lady.
Yeah.
So, just, you know, not real, not real pleasant to be around. So we went and checked for a pair of boots at Rural King, and they had cowboy boot style, but they were work boots, so they didn't have any cowboy boots. So she said, well, just check and see online. So I got everything I needed online plus the Spurs.
Yeah.
For almost $100 less than what we was gonna spend there.
Yeah.
And nicer boots, too.
And they came before the wedding, thank goodness.
And they came before the wedding. The bolo should be in tomorrow, so.
Yeah. So you'll be pretty
And bad. We bought a shirt at Walmart, and we still come out almost $100, well, like $90-some cheaper than what we would have bought there, and I still wouldn't have had my Spurs.
Right.
So, all right. Here's what they look like, guys. If I can get you down here. There's what they look like.
Oh, they look nice.
Yeah, these are sharp, buddy.
Walk around in them for a moment.
She wants me to walk.
Yeah, I want you to feel them. Okay. Feel the feeling.
Oh, yeah, once these are broke in, these will be fine.
Yeah.
Yeah. These are show spurs, by the way, too, for those of you that don't know. So, what we're going to do
is...
Huh?
I'm glad they fit.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, these straps are really, really nice. So let's go ahead and get a set of spurs here. There is a left and right. They will fit either way, but they don't fit right and they don't look right. So this one will go on the right because you want your thing pointing out. Get you down here. Maybe you can see something here. Alright, let's go ahead and put our spurs on here. Okay, so what we want to do is, let me see. I think it goes like that.
Okay. Were they bought the same people or are they different people?
The spurs, yeah. It's called up here somewhere. Right here. Oh, they sent me a card too.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, a business card with a thank you letter. Cool.
enjoying God bless. It's from the Morris family.
So it must be family run.
Well, that's cool.
Tack discounters.
That's them right there.
Well, that's neat because at least you're supporting
the bike. And they've got
a small business.
They have got all kinds of stuff.
So first thing we need to do, now these are hard to do at first because of the leather
so tough, you know. So these will have to be, I may have to cut you off for a minute. These have to go on here like this, and then these will go around to the other like this.
Now you do it with the boot on, or you take your boot off and have to do it?
No, you have to put them on after you put your boot on.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So do you leave them on once you put it on your boot, it's good to go and you can leave them on? Or do you take them off every time?
No, well, you just take them off, but there will only be one strap like that, and you take it off, take your boot off.
Oh, okay.
So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to try to stretch this over here, guys. And this is a pain in the ass. I've had to soak these before, these straps, in warm water to get them to go over. So I may have to cut you off and turn you back on once I get these on, then we'll put them on the boots. Okay.
Let me
shut you off and I'll turn you back on. Okay. All right. I got them on.
One went on really good, really easy. Well, not really easy, but snug like it should. The other one gave me a little problem, but like I said, I'll stretch out and hopefully I won't have that problem with this side because it's got to come around and go like that. All right. So let's see. Wrong side. I got to get this side on here.
Be careful.
Huh?
Be careful.
Be careful what?
That chair.
I know. It'll probably fall over on me.
No. All right, so you want to get these back up here. And
this comes around the front.
I just knocked my mic off. Yeesh. Sorry guys. Okay. Now this is going to come around here. Come on. Oh, chair's flipping. And more times you guys take these off, the better they'll get. There they go. Alright. So there's my Spurs. Get them, put them back here and adjust the, you gotta adjust your buckle just like you would any belt, which can be a pain too. So let me take these off. Oh crap. There we go. Alright, so I'm going to tighten them up, probably second to the last hole, maybe the last hole, we'll just have to see. And that's just a belt that comes through here. And also when you take these off, once you get these worn in, you take them off, just like a new belt, they get easier, so. Alright. So anyhow, shove this up through. I can't see nothing. This up through here. And pull this out. Just like you do a belt, you can see what's going on there. Anyway, I'm going to do that. And I'll be back with you guys in just a second. All right.
I just turned you, this is from Fish, this stuff here you guys see, okay. Which I think is on my camera. But, okay guys, there you go. What'd you say, Monk?
What?
A second ago?
Are they hot?
Yeah. There's one.
Nice,
I went to the last hole, so I'll do that on.
She'll be proud of you.
On this one. And I will be wearing my Stetson hat and my belt. I was trying to find a belt with the buckle, the Praying Cowboy, but no. Now the other side came out real easy, didn't it?
Now they match.
There we go. I go to. Did I go to the last hole on the other one? That's why I got a brown belt too.
Yeah.
These are hand tooled too, this leather.
Yeah.
It's all handmade, yeah, hand stitched and well whatever they do handmade wise.
Right.
I figure they probably use a machine to stitch them, but jeans up here. Oh, here we go again. I may have to work this a few times. Alright, so you get the idea. Now I'm gonna get this put on and off a couple times like I did the other one, and I'll be back with you. All right, number two, put this on here. There we go.
Got it?
Close. They get easier, trust me, guys.
Well, it's brand new.
Yeah. It's part of cowboying up. All right.
All right. I like them a lot.
There's thousands of different straps and spurs you can get. All right. So, there they are. All right. So, cool.
Yeah.
All right, now let's see if the belt fits. Take this belt off.
That's a pretty belt.
Make sure I got it. You can put these on right or left. Hopefully the belt will fit. These jeans have 7 belt loops. That's good. But this buckle will come off and can go on other belts. So, yeah, like I can get a black belt or whatever, white belt. There we go. So, awesome. And my boots again. I like them. Cool. And they feel great. Awesome. Cool buckles. So, there it is. My bolo. That should be here tomorrow. So. Alright, I'll get you up here and we'll talk. Okay guys, so there's my spurs and my boots and my belt. In case you guys never put on a pair of Spurs, that's what it involves the first time. If you got a used pair, they'll buckle right in. But usually two or three times, they'll start getting, you know, I mean, you don't want them falling off either, so.
Now you gotta take those off every time you take your boots off?
Yeah, because your foot won't come out.
Oh, it won't?
No. If that was the case, your Spurs would fall off. So, you can sit and play with them, you know, just, but it's cool. I like, thank you, Mama. So, and then I'll have my hat, my bolo, white shirt, so should be what she's looking for her wedding, so that'll be Sunday. I don't know if I'll film any of that, because that's her day, and
because,
yeah, I'm going to film a bunch of stuff for, I'm going to film it all for her, and then I'm going to make her a nice DVD, and then I'll give her the memory cards in case she wants pictures and stuff printed off, so.
Maybe we'll talk about it after.
Okay, yeah, we can do that. Or before we go or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we'll film some of us, but I, you know, I'm not gonna film her. She's in her 50s and first time she's ever been married, so she's very excited and it's gonna be a very special day for her, so. She's been waiting a long time to be married, so. And 4 years ago when she was gonna get married, I had plans to come down here because I still lived in Ohio now. Around four years, yeah, right before I moved down here, I had plans. I told her I couldn't make it. She's like, that's okay, but I already had plans to come down. And I was just going to show up like the day before. And then she gets hold of me and said that he had gotten cold feet. Well, she said, I said, why? What's wrong? She said, cold feet. I said, you or him? She said, him. So. 4 years later,
same guy.
So hopefully they'll go through with it this time.
Yeah. So people might be hurting.
Yeah. So anyways, a little story on that, but that's why I got these, was for her wedding. So because I wasn't just going to spend this kind of money on boots and Spurs just for no reason.
No, you've been wanting.
But so it kind of served a dual purpose. Yeah. So. All right, guys. Well, I'm gonna say bye-bye for now. We still gotta unload the truck, so.
Yeah.
What do you say, Monk?
Monk says so for now, y'all. Have a great week.
Check out her videos. You got two up, right?
Yeah.
All right. I'll probably put this one up first, and then I'll do the camping video. Yes, yeah, her five fishes. Heard this all night and all day. Her and her five fishes. And her 25-inch mudfish. Thing bit me and kept flopping off tailgate. I couldn't measure him. I was like, threw him up there. And he flopped back down again. I was like,
he was fighting, wasn't he?
Yeah, and I was like, all right, I'll just measure him on the ground, you know?
Yeah.
So he made me. I don't know, did you get that on video where I threw him up there?
No, I didn't cut that part out.
Oh, did you?
Yeah,
I wasn't yelling and screaming. There's a difference. When I said, damn it, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, I wasn't. I mean, he bit me three times, you know. He bit me on my thumb. He bit me on my finger. He bit me over here.
He was quite a fighter.
I've been bitten three times. And then I just wanted to get a measurement and let him go, you know. He's biting the hell out of me, so. But I wasn't yelling and screaming. There's a big difference. I was like, son of a bitch. And I threw him up on the tailgate of the truck and he stayed there just till I got the measuring stick ready. He flopped back down off again.
Yeah.
I was like, the hell with it. So I measured him on the ground. I put him back and then he started swimming back towards me.
Maybe he was going to bite you again.
Like, go out that way, idiot. Finally, he turned around and I seen the wake. I seen he was gone. Mean fish.
Yeah.
Mean son of a bitch, man.
He was mean.
He was almost as mean as that gar I caught.
No, bottom fish must be very aggressive.
That gar was, well, the gar was meaner, but, I mean, he was pretty mean, but, you know, 25 inches, 2.5 feet long, that's a pretty good sized fish. He probably weighed 5 to 8 pounds, so.
Yeah.
Because I'm holding him trying to get his hook out. My arm's getting tired and sore. Like holding a gallon of milk, whatever that weighs.
It's probably at least 5 pounds.
Oh yeah.
So, all right, guys. So anyway, check her channel out. It's pretty cool. Like I said, when we're in the tent, I'll do a quick voiceover for you. I won't show it all because then, but I'll show you mic issues. So, but we was in the tent talking and didn't record no audio. So. I got shit better than Mr. Man Legend gone for now. Monkey says she's out. And I want to say we'll see you guys soon. And don't forget to check her out. She's got some cool videos. And she's getting more and more. So please subscribe to her too. So like I said before, she's one of my featured channels. So go to my channel. Go over to the right. Click on Monkey 1000. Subscribe. We'll see you guys soon. Bye bye. And take care. Check one. Not a word.